John the Evangelist, and all of you who have come for this Mass of Thanksgiving. We're very honored to have His Eminence here, and we're very happy that all of you can join us for this Mass.
Thank you, Father Mario, and I too am grateful to be able to be with so many people from this part of our Archdiocese, my brother priests and deacons and Bishop Campbell, and all of us gather on the Feast of St. Martin de Porres. What a wonderful celebration it is for us on this day that honors a man of tremendous generosity and meekness of heart. Let us ask the Father now to forgive our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, bless St. Martin de Porres by the path of humility to heavenly glory. Grant that we may so follow his radiant example in this life as to merit to be exalted with him in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
O Lord, my heart is not proud, nor are my eyes haughty. I busy not myself with great things, nor with things too sublime for me.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
Nay, rather, I have stilled and quieted my soul like a weaned child on its mother's lap, so is my soul within me.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
O Israel, hope in the Lord, both now and forever.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
Thank you. with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment of the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest of the and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord.
Again, I'd like to thank Father Mario and the people of St. John's for allowing us to gather in their church and in their hall this day to accomplish something that I'd like to share with you. I believe it was one of the benefits of the COVID lockdown. Now, you might say, Cardinal, there were no benefits for the COVID lockdown. But I do believe that, at least in the Archdiocese, we have begun another practice which is much better than our former practice. Every year in the past, before COVID, the Cardinal offered an evening of thanks for people who were generous to the annual appeal. But it meant that people had to come to the cathedral. And if the traffic then was like the traffic now, it was not a happy trip to come from different parts of our archdiocese down to the cathedral. So we have decided, the people in the chancery, myself, and my advisor, that it's much better for the cardinal to go to about 7 or 8 parishes throughout the year to thank the people for their generosity and their support of the annual appeal, but it's also an opportunity in the presence of my brother priests to thank our people for being supportive and generous to their parish. Because let's face it, if your generosity and your kindness was not beneficial to the parishes, we would be in very serious trouble. So that's why so many of the pastors are here, make sure that I start by saying thank you for being generous to our parishes. And that's really from the heart. The work and generosity and the support that you provide for our local communities is indispensable. And during the COVID lockdown, we were so grateful that so many people continued their support of their parishes, even when they were not able to be in the churches themselves physically during a good portion of the COVID lockdown. But also, I'm here to say thank you, as St. Paul's letter to us urges us to be thankful in the Lord. Thankful for the generosity that you have extended to your parishes and your generosity to the annual appeal. Many people aren't sure of what benefit is the annual appeal. I mean, don't we give to our parishes? Don't we support the local communities? And you do, very generously, very enthusiastically. But the appeal allows the Archdiocese to accomplish things together. It's a joint venture that allows us to support the pro-life activities, the seminary activities, the Catholic charities, the retired priests. It allows us to do something in a corporate fashion that simple parish activities would not
allow us to do. So thank you. Thank you, thank you for that. It makes us a stronger community. It makes us a more vibrant community. And it's another gesture that we do things most effectively when we do them together. When we put our gifts together, we can accomplish so much good for so many different people in ways that individuals, even individual parishes, would not be able to achieve. So thank you for your kindness, your support, your generosity, and your faith. Your faith in your parishes, the faith that continues to make those communities vibrant and loving and healthy and healthy and allows them to carry on the mission of the church. So thank you in my name, but in the name of all of the pastors, those who are here and will report to their neighbors, yes, he did thank you for being grateful to the parish. But also, thank you for your kindness to the annual appeal. It's almost a fortunate event that we gather on the feast of St. Martin de Porres, a man who distinguished himself by his kindness. By his kindness. Even in his own lifetime, the people of Lima, Peru, knew that this brother, this Dominican brother, was there for them. He fed the poor. He learned some skills, some rudimentary skills in medical care. So he cared for the poor. He fed the poor. And he's often, like St. Francis, pictured with little animals, cats and mice and things. Because even the animal world knew that they were dealing with a holy, generous man. He was also, as everyone knows, a child of mixed racial heritage. And so he brought together, in his own person, the wonderful gifts of the Latino community and the African community. So he stands as a model of how we are supposed to work together across our racial and cultural and language differences to reflect the love of Christ. St. Martin de Porres is a very significant man, obviously here in the United States, because he stands as a symbol of racial harmony and reconciliation. But he also is important to the lives of the Peruvian people. On his feast day today, the people in Peru have a grand parade, and they march around the city with statues of St. Martin because they claim him as their own. They're proud that this Dominican lay brother was able to grow to holiness within that one community by his generosity, and his reputation is spread throughout the world. So on this day, St. Martin's Day, we gather to thank God for all the things that God has done for us, and we ask him to make us as generous and caring for others as was St. Martin de Porres when he cared for the people of Lima, Peru. St. Martin de Porres,
pray for us.
Let us stand now and speak to the Father Almighty. As dear brothers and sisters, may every prayer of our hearts be directed for his will. It is in that humanity that we should be saved and come to know the knowledge and the love of the truth.
For the Holy Church of God, that the Lord may graciously watch over her and care for her, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of all the world, that the Lord may graciously preserve harmony among them and for peace in the world, especially in Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For and in thanksgiving for those who have faithfully supported our local church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And this evening, let us also embrace in prayer the people in Lima, Peru, who rejoice this day that within their midst a great saint was raised up. For the people of Lima, Peru, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, our refuge and our strength, hear the prayers of your church, for you yourself are the source of all devotion. And grant, we pray, that what we ask for in faith we may truly obtain through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join me in singing Psalm number 611, For the Complete of the Earth. Psalm number 611.
Thank you.
one they quote as the new man in your image, the old having passed away. Graciously grant, we pray, that renewed like him, we may offer you the acceptable sacrifice of conciliation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ, for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promised in the new world to come. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Martin de Porres, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
In this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Wilton, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, and your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind witness to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
Thank you.
let us pray. By the power of the sacrament, Lord, we pray. Lead us always in your love. Through the example of Blessed Martin de Porres, and bring to fulfillment the good work you have begun in us, until the day of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Once again, as Pastor St. John, it's my pleasure to say once again thank you to Cardinal Wilton Gregory for joining us in celebrating this Mass, as well as Bishop Campbell and my brother priest who have joined us this day, and Your Eminence. We are very thankful that you told them how much we're thankful for them. I know that you are always welcome here at St. John's. It's a great honor for us to have you here. And please note to everyone, if you would please join us immediately after the final blessing downstairs in the hall, which you can go down the stairs to the right, or there's an elevator on this side. If you would like, Cardinal Gregory will be saying hello to everyone down there and joining us for a little bit. And once again, thank you for joining us here at St. John's.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in singing our closing hymn, Psalm number 430, For the Fruits of This Creation. Psalm number 430.